Now, let us study about the energy of electron and Bohr energy levels. Now, for Bohr energy levels or various orbits of an atom, here we can see that in an orbit, total energy of electron is given as, this can be written as total energy is equals to the sum of kinetic energy in nth orbit plus potential energy in nth orbit. If we simply calculate the kinetic energy of electrons in nth orbit, then it can be directly given as half mvn square. And potential energy is purely the electrostatic potential energy of electron, because gravitational potential energy here will be negligible because of negligible mass in electron. So this energy can be given as minus kZd square by Rn, because potential energy we know for two charge system is written as kQ1Q2 by R. Here, because of attractive forces, it will be negative. And by first postulate, as we know, mvn square we can write as kZd square over Rn. We can substitute the value of kinetic energy as half kZd square over Rn minus kZd square over Rn. This will give us the total energy of electron in nth orbit, which is minus half kZd square over Rn. Here we can see this is the total energy. If we just have a look on the kinetic energy, it is half kZd square by Rn. The potential energy is negative of the twice of this value. So here we can write, here we can see in this situation, the magnitude of total energy is equals to magnitude of kinetic energy, which is equals to half of the magnitude of potential energy. And this is the same relation we use. This is the relation among energies when a particle revolves under an inverse square force influence. Here you can see in case of gravitation also, if you deduce the relation of total energy, kinetic energy and potential energy of a particle which is revolving around another particle under the influence of gravitational force, the same relation will hold, because here we can state that this is the relation which is there for all moving particles in a circular orbit under inverse square force influence. On the next sheet, let's continue on the elaborated form of energy of electron in nth orbit. In continuation, let's discuss about the energy of electron in nth orbit. On the previous sheet, we have deduced the result is minus half kZd square over Rn. If we substitute the value of Rn, which we know the radius of another orbit is given as n square h square over 4 pi square kZd square m. If we substitute the value of Rn over here, you can see the value of nth orbit energy we are getting minus half kZd square over, I'm just substituting the value of Rn, which is n square h square by 4 pi square kZd square m. And on further simplifying, you can see the value of En we are getting here is minus 2 pi square k square z square E4m by n square h square. Here in this term, I can also separate the constant terms, as for various atoms, hydrogenic atoms and various orbits, it may vary. So here it will be minus 2 pi square k square E4m by h square multiplied by z square over n square. If we substitute the value of all constants and we calculate in units of electron volts, here the total energy we'll be getting is minus 13.6 multiplied by z square by n square electron volt. So both of these expressions are useful for you to keep in mind, because various numericals are we are going to see in coming sections based on these results. Here, always remember, if you wish to convert it into joules, then the conversion factor is 1 electron volt is 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 joules. That can also be done easily.